Don't ask me how I did that, because I don't know. I have no idea how I did that, but it works. Hello, fashion sewers. I hope you are well. If you're new to my channel, I'm Colleen G. Lee. Let's get straight into the video. And in this video tutorial, I'm going to be refashioning this gorgeous jacket and making it even more gorgeouser. Is any such word? No, I don't think so. But I'm going to make it into a nice, gorgeous jacket. I'm going to try it on in a moment so that you can see how it doesn't fit very well. It's a couple of sizes too big for me. And it's going to be a quick and simple, maybe not so quick, but it's going to be a simple project anyway to do. And the results are stunning. And I can't wait to show you. So let me get this on and show you how easy this is going to be. All that I'm going to be needing is a button for this amazing transformation. Just a button. And the results are just, as you probably can tell from the thumbnail, are just amazing. I just can't wait to wear it and see how it functions. That's going to be the next challenge for me, but it should be fine. It should be fine. Anyway, let's get to the video.
Okay, so I've got the jacket on. And as you can see, it is too big for me. Let's turn around. So how I'm going to do this is so easy. It really is very simple. So I'm going to turn the jacket the other way around. So I'm going to be wearing it back to front. Let's do that now. And it already looks good. And the trick is to make sure it doesn't feel uncomfortable. So because you've got it back to front, obviously the neck here feels okay actually. It doesn't feel so strangling me. And that can feel a bit uncomfortable for some people, but it's okay. I think as long as your jacket is a couple of sizes too big, it shouldn't feel that comfortable. And actually it does feel comfortable in the fact that it won't fall off my body because I've got it the wrong way around. I suppose you could think of it in those terms. But just look at the sleeves, look at these slits that you would never have noticed the other way around. So that adds to the feature of this jacket. And all I'm going to do is cross it over, or turn around, cross it over like this. So I've got the button crossed over on that side. I want to make sure I've got the buttonhole on this side. And place it like so. This pull. This style may not be for everyone, but I certainly like it. It's not the first time I've done this technique. I've done this technique before where wearing jackets that have been back to front, especially men's jackets. It looks cute. So I'm right around here. This is where I'm going to be putting the button here. Just get a pin. You can see me. You can see my thumb there. So it should be about here. Okay, pin is in. Making sure it's not pinned to my jumper. Okay. So it's out there. And then all I'm going to do is put the button there and show you the results. Look, it looks really good now as I'm showing you. That looks good. And you've got a little bit of a fold that's happening here, which I'll explain a little bit more once I've put the button on and I've styled it a bit. And you can see you've got a couple of options with how you can figure this out for yourself, whether you want it to be how I'm going to be having it, but I'll describe that a little bit later. So let's just get this button on now and try and jack it on again.
I've got my marker there for where I'm going to be putting my button. I've got my needle and thread, and I've got a flat button. do have a video tutorial on how to sew on a button, so I'll link that in the description.
So now, as you can see the back, that looks gorgeous already. And the slits and the sleeves just add another dimension onto it. I'm going to talk to you about this here that's happening. So if I come closer, you can see there's a fold here. Now I love it, it's beautiful, but if you wanted to, the turn side on, you can always tack it down if you feel uncomfortable about that and want to get rid of it. But it's the only way you can actually, well, it isn't the only way. If you want to do more work, it would be a case of taking off the collar and then reducing the back neck, cutting that away. But it probably wouldn't really work, actually, because it means too much removing of the shoulder seams to get it to be reduced, but I just think it just adds to it. I think it's just gorgeous, that fold there. And if I turn around slowly, and the fact you can see it's been worn back to front, it's definitely Colleen G. Lee style. Definitely. It reminds me of my younger days when I used to do fun things like this. Yeah. I just think it's cute, I really do. So the only other thing I need to do now is to figure out the placement for this button here, the original button on the jacket, so that it stays in place. So, you'll need to do that. Feels comfortable. I think I need a pin that's going to be out here. Let's just check. Yeah. I think that is going to be the place where the button is. Just get a pin. And there. Oh, there we go. So I'm not sure how I'm going to sew that into place. And then I would wear this with my belt. Got this elasticated belt, and I just think it's going to make it even more special. But yeah, quick and simple but extremely effective look to refashioning a jacket. And we do have to make sure that the inner button is going to be quite secure as well, so it feels comfortable. You don't want to feel as though it's falling off your body.
I'm here to inspire, motivate and share ideas for refashioning clothing. If you are into that sort of thing, consider subscribing, and let's get back to the video. This is the original button. There's my pin. So we need to work on the inside. Let me just mark that through to the lining. Yeah, there we go. So now what I need to do now is, I've got some cord elastic here, so I'm going to use cord elastic. You could use, there is a method, what is it again, Colleen? I'll put a link to it in the description, I forgot what it's called now. Thread chain, there's another word for it as well, which you could do a thread loop, you could do that as well. But I just want to experiment with using elastic. Should I put a knot in? Right, so. So once I've got this on, button will be there. So, if I do that, then it can be captured, can't it? Like a hook. Yeah, I'll do that. Okay. So I'll put a knot in first. Nice strong knot. Should I do two? I'm going to do two. Knot it twice. Okay. Now I'm just going to do it just a straight. Let me just cut some of that away. See if this works. And then do it like that. Okay, so I'm going to just get the lining. I don't want it to go to through to the other side. Remove the pin. There it is. I can just about see where I put needle to begin with. Right, so if I pull it through, just do a small one. Just thinking this through. Bear with me. It doesn't have to be this long either. So if I do like that, create another one here, should be able to hook it. Yes, put it through like that. Yeah, I think that's gonna work. Yeah, that should work. Created a knot. Let's see if I can keep that knot in. Let's see, it will be my friend. Yes. Don't ask me how I did that because I don't know. I have no idea how I did that, but it works. I think it's going to work. Let's see. I think I may have invented something here, invented a technique. Okay, I'm going to cut some of that off. And let's see, I put it through here. You still want it to look neat and tidy. And tie another one, which it will do. But remember, we are refashioning. And we will, in time, well, I believe, get used to how we are refashioning clothing and reducing the impact on the planet. Yeah, it's pretty stable to me. I'm going to cut the rest of that away, but I just want to make sure that it does. Once I've tried it on, yeah, that should be fine. Yes! Okay. Yes, that should work. Let's try this on, let's see if it works.
It's going to be tricky putting this on. Yeah, it will be, but it's fashion, so it's okay. Okay, so there's the leaf. Button through. Yes. The next button. Get in there. Yeah, it's fine. Happy. footwear with it as well. That is gorgeous. How simple is that? It wasn't too tricky putting it on either. That is gorgeous. Yeah. I'll just show you the back. You just have to get used to how some look when you see the back of someone. But that's gorgeous still. That is.
This is so nice. So happy with the results. All it took is one button, and I think I invented a technique there with the loop for the extra button, which was the original button on the jacket. So yeah, I think I'm going to have to copyright that, I think, somehow. I don't know. Anyway, let me see, any advice and tips? Is it uncomfortable getting into? It's not uncomfortable, it's just tricky. And you know, if you've got problems, you know, trying to get your hands around the back, it's always a good idea to have a spare person around. If I did, I would use that person. But it's not impossible. I mean, that's fashion for you sometimes, isn't it? Where something can look really amazing and getting in and out of it can be the secret to how some garments are actually created. And whether you are the type of person who's willing to invest in that garment, even though it can be a little bit tricky to get into, but the results, what can I say? If you didn't want to use the elastic technique, you can always use the threaded loop technique. That would be just as good. You probably could even use ribbon as well, a little narrow ribbon if you wanted to. That should be alright. Feels comfortable to me at the moment, the technique that I've just used and invented, just saying. but no, just go for it. Make sure the jacket is, I would say, it definitely would have to be a couple of sizes bigger than what you are, because remember, we're talking about the breast area being at the back of the body of the jacket, if that makes sense. It does, doesn't it? So you want to make sure that it is a little bit bigger. Get used to the fact that when we are refashioning, that clothes are not going to look perhaps as aesthetically pleasing as we would want them to be, or what we are kind of programmed to see garments as, unless it's, you know, garments that are made by designers that are in the deconstruction kind of designs to their garments. But no, this we have to, as I can foresee, as I am doing all these refashioning, that garments are going to look a little bit off kilter a little bit, and that's fine. That's the beauty in a garment that's been refashioned. The key is it comfortable? Yes. Do you like it? Yes. And would you wear it again and again? Absolutely. And if you enjoyed this video tutorial, please give it a thumbs up, and please do share with your friends. If you have any comments or queries, put those in the comment box below, and I will see you next time.